Okay, so today's assignment is to draft a bra cup with an underwire. That's what we are going to do. If you watch several CLO videos, there's different ways to do it. The method that we're going to do is we're going to basically draft an underwire shape, and then to make it hard, we're going to freeze it. And then we'll finish drafting the bra cup and sew it to the frozen piece. At the end, we can change the fabric of that frozen underwire to some metal properties and see what happens. But based on my experience, probably the most effective way to make the underwire is to freeze it. Okay, so here we go. In CLO's video, they use the 3D pen tool, and they actually draw right on the avatar where they want the underwire to be, and then they flatten it. And when you flatten something, it turns it into a 2D pattern. I don't know if that's an older video and things have been updated, but I was noticing that I am not getting the shape I wanted from that. I'll go ahead and demonstrate it for you. So I ended up just drafting the wire shape myself, but I'm gonna go ahead and try using the 3D pen tool. So this is to draw right on the avatar. Up here are 3D pen tools to draw on garments, but we're gonna draw on the avatar. So I click to make a curve. I'm gonna hold command because I'm on a Mac. If you're on a PC, you would hold control. Just does a couple curve points. Oops. You can see that it's a red dot every time I'm holding down the command or control button to get that curve. Oh, it ended. Oh, I didn't mean to do that. Let's try that one more time. I'm gonna make it a curve point again. So, in the clothes video, they make it look so simple. You just switch to flatten and make it be selected blue, click, hit enter. That one looks okay. I was doing it earlier and they're like way more straight and kind of funky. This isn't really the shape that I want though, so I think I'm gonna go in and manipulate it, or maybe I just draw my own, honestly. So I can use the pattern drafting tool, polygon. And I think what I'm gonna do is just click and drag, and click. and I think I'll go straight across. I'm actually gonna bring this down a little bit lower. I'm gonna hit the letter Z, make it a little bit lower like that. Maybe we'll bring him out a bit. Okay, then I'm gonna offset the bottom part. Offset as an internal line, I'm gonna make it 0.20. 2.5 inches, quarter inch. Okay, then I'm gonna right click and say cut. And then I'm gonna toss letter A, select that piece and toss it. I'm also gonna toss that guy too. And so I wanna use this as my underwire. Okay, I'm gonna get rid of, let's see here, the 3D pen tool drawing. So I'm gonna do the edit thing and you just click it, it should delete. Okay, so now another video, this one's from CLO's Hong Kong office. The way that they did the underwire is they imported a pattern piece, just kind of like what I have here, and then they added pins to it. So let's pull up the pins under this tool down the bottom. I'm just gonna do box, I'm gonna click it. Oh, another thing CLO does recommend is switching the particle distance on this piece down to 3. Maybe I'll do that in a minute if this isn't gonna work for me. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and try to get this close to the avatar. I'm not gonna use the arrangement points because I actually want it to stay pretty straight. I don't want it to wrap around her too much. I wanna control it. Let's see what I think of that. Okay, I'm going to put in spacebar. I know there's pins there, so I'm going to use the select pin tool to grab it. It will let me, or no, because it's inside. There we go. You know what? I think I should switch the particle distance. So I'm going to select this piece, open up our property editor, and under simulation properties, let's change it to 3. So you just kind of want to get it to lay pretty flat and close to her body. I'm going to unsimulate, so I can lower the whole thing. Oops, actually looks kind of far. Okay. Okay, this will do. So there's my underwire. Now what I want to do is go ahead and select it. I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna solidify it. And then I'm also going to freeze it. Cool. Okay, so now I'm gonna go ahead and draw my bra cup. And this time I think using the 3D pen tool should work well for us. So again, if it has a white arrow, it's the edit one. So I wanna click the one below and I last used flatten. So I need to hover over and make sure I'm on 3D pen. Avatar, and I want to sew through the bottom of my underwire. So I'm going to go ahead and click around that. Again, for curves, I hold command because I'm on a Mac. If you're on a PC, you would hold control. You can see all those red dots mean that it's a curve point. The end, I'm going to let go, and then I'm going to hold curve again. And I'm going to add a seam line as well to get a good fit. Okay, now let's make this a pattern piece. So we switch to the flatten tool, so we'll flatten this into a 2D pattern piece. Okay, so once it turns kind of blue, it's a little finicky. Click it, hold shift, and we're actually going to have hold shift. Click, and then hit enter. And let's see what that looks like. Not the prettiest. I could probably fix it a little bit. So let's move these pieces. Okay. I'm going to clean it up a little bit. I'm going to bring this up. I'm going to hit the letter C. I'm going to curve this guy a little bit. Actually, what I'm going to do is use my smooth curve tool. I want to curve this part, so I'll click it. Blue, and then I have my new line. I just pull it out. Okay, that's just a better, cleaner pattern. Now I should true it up, make sure everything can actually be sewn together. So I'll hit the letter Z. These two will get sewn together. This first line is 5.3. This one's 5.3 if you round up, kind of close enough. And then I also want to sew it to the bottom of this guy. So what I want to do is take this and turn this into a curve point. So if I select here, that's 4, hold shift, plus the other 4, it's 8.3. What is this? Okay, it's a little bit bigger. So I can probably make this a little bit smaller. I think I'm bringing this one a little bit smaller by 0.3 inches. because I think the shape is just a little funny. 20.3. That's really good. Okay. Let's check it. 8.0. Perfect. Okay. So I'm going to use my sew tool. Oh, those were already sewn together. All right. Nice. Fabulous. Okay. And then I think I will use segment, but M to N, because there's two of them. So 1, 2, I am mindful of those notches. Okay, great. And then I also want to sew the inside to the inside wireframe. So I need to make an internal line. I'm gonna select that guy, right click, and offset as internal line. I wanna offset it 0.25 inches, perfect. Same with this side. And I'm going to sew those internal lines to the inner part of the circle. Should get rid of those points. Ooh, I'm scared that's going to be a mess. It's probably okay, but it just, I don't like it. So I'm going to hit Z, right click, convert to curve. Just make it a little bit cleaner. I don't need those points. Try that again. Click enter and enter. Cool. Better. Actually, I don't know if that's right. I don't like it. I'm going to delete it again. And it looks like I did not get the bottom one sewn like I thought. I'm going to try free sewing and then instead. Click. Click. Hit return. Click. 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 Okay, that looks good because there's no crisscross. Return. Yes. Let's try it again. Click. Click. Return. Click, 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 return. Okay, good. That looks better. Okay. What else do we need to do before we simulate? Let's see what's going to happen. Okay, I'm going to simulate. So it looks like the cup is still a little bit too big at the top. So I want to take some of it in. So I think what I'll do is maybe bring this in a little bit. That kind of takes away some, so maybe it'll be a little smaller and it'll fit better. Yeah. Maybe we can do the same on the other side. It looks like there's a little bit of gapping. Okay. And then the other thing we really should do is put elastic in. So I'm going to select it, open up Property Editor, and click on Elastic. Ooh, doesn't like that. Change it to 100. Okay, I'm going to select these two pieces. Reset the 3D arrangement. Isolate it again. There we go. Cool. Okay, great. Okay, so now I can copy it and paste one for the other side. So I'm going to right click and we'll say clone symmetric pattern with sewing. Okay. And then space by height too. Okay, awesome. And then if I wanted to continue, I could actually open up that other bathing suit we drafted already and bring in the back straps and sew it all, just kind of finish a project. But this project, I just really want you guys to focus on making the underwire. So just if you get to this part, you are done, you can turn it in, and that's fine. Couple questions you might be asking, why is that blue? It's a layers issue. So the underwire is protruding over our fabric. So what I could do is select the fabric pieces, and then I would change the layer. So it's set to layer zero because that's closest to the body. So I'm going to leave the underwire at zero, close to the body. I'm going to change this to be layer one. Okay. It doesn't like it. CLO does not like when you do it. I'm going to spacebar just so it can see how now it's going on top of the underwire. Hit spacebar, and then I can select everything, come back, and change everything back to layer zero. Shows on layer zero? Yes. Spacebar again. Okay. I did talk about what if we change this guy to a metal, which we can do, but before we do that, we would have to add the back and the rest of the pieces too, so that it's actually on the dress form, because as is, it would just fall off. So I'll go ahead and add those pieces, and then I'll play around by changing these to actual metal and unfreezing them, and let's see if that works.